Why in the...
Dude, I'm gonna go and watch the video. I'm gonna look for the videos. I'm gonna see if you can hear us.
Alright, so if I could get you guys to look at your homework here. Okay. Somebody asked about number 9, and then somebody asked about number 20. So on number 9, we're gonna split this up. So integral x cubed over 2x squared, x over 2x squared, and 4 over 2x squared. Here, I'm going to write this as 1 half times 1 over x. I think if we wrote that as 1 over 2x, we might not see the natural log piece. So I can write it like that. That's fine. Okay. And then this is going to be 2 over x squared dx. So then I'm going to apply power rule on the first one. Natural log rule on the second. And then if this was 2x to the negative 2, I would have x to the negative 1 divided by negative 1, and then plus. And that's one of the rules that I had you guys do a note card for, so that you guys could remember that one there. Alright, on number 20, this has been asked a lot today. Let me ask you this really quickly so that I know. On number 20, is it you didn't know the antiderivative or you didn't know how to evaluate?
Evaluate.
So what is the antiderivative of secant tangent?
Secant?
Just secant. So we're looking at the secant function. And I want to evaluate pi over 3 and negative pi over 3. So here's pi over 3. The 60 degree angle. I'm going to label that here for pi over 3. Now, secant is 1 over cosine. So if cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, secant is hypotenuse over adjacent. So that's how I got 2 over 1 here. And then all students take calculus, even though I'm at negative pi over 3, it's still going to be a positive 2 over 1. So that's how I got to do this. Maybe another trig tutorial in our future?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't
know
what's up with
trig.
I
want to
know what's up with
trig. I'm not saying, because I have to be part of it, but I want to know what's up with trig.
All right, so in your notes under lesson 5, okay, is the daily quiz for today. So if you look, 18, that's our daily quiz for today. Now on this daily quiz, okay, only choose 2. I'm going to give you 4 minutes. Choose 2, so it's going to be out of 4. Now if you want to be all extra and do more than 2, you can, and you can get 1 extra bonus point each for the other 2. So you could get 6 out of 4 if you get all 4 of them correct. Okay? But just choose 2. I'm going to give you some choice on this one. 4 minutes. Okay?
Thank you.
you get all four correct, you give yourself some little bonus points for this, okay? So basically, you get a point for the overall derivative, knowing that, and then a point for the chain rule, because they're all chain rules. So go ahead and check the two that you would get those 4 points for first, and then also give yourself extra bonus point for each one that you got fully correct after that. Let me know if that doesn't make sense, okay? And I can help you check yours.
Keep forgetting to do the chain rule.
Okay, forgetting to do the chain, yeah. What else? Which ones did we attempt? Skip number two, okay? Skip number one, that radical is kind of scary. So three and four is where we went?
Yeah.
Okay? Did anybody like number two? I like number two.
Yeah, no. I kind of forgot how to do two.
No. Okay. So where we need to go, okay, and we're going to practice this all week long. Where we need to go with this is how are we going to undo the chain rule piece. So instead of having nice, pretty integrals, I'm going to say, and I chose number two here on purpose since that's y'all's favorite. Find me the antiderivative of that, or find me the function whose derivative is this. And we got to figure out how we can get from here to here. Right? Because the derivative of this, using chain rule, would be this one here. So we got to learn how to undo the chain rule. How do we undo this? Now we're going to do that using what's called USA, okay? So common places to find U, to call U, is U likes to hide inside parentheses and raise to a power. So look at problem number four, right? That has stuff raised to the fourth power, and then notice it's four stuff to the third D stuff, right? So one place I'm going to look, right here on the first problem when we do this, is if I have something raised to a power, that might be what I want to call U. If I have a radical and a function inside the radical, that's probably what I want to call U. Especially if that radical is in a denominator. Okay? If I can write the entire denominator as U, that's usually a good sign, because then I would have natural log as my antiderivative, okay? So being able to rewrite something as 1 over U is going to be nice. Even though you guys don't like it, if I have an E to a function, I'm going to call that function part U. And then also inside trig function. You like to hide it by trig. So how we're going to do these model problems. 1, what do you think we should call you, given these bullet points that I just gave you, okay? And then number 2, take the integral of the integral on your calculator, not what's on your paper, okay? That's like my hint step to you as to what we should be doing, okay? So look at model problem number 1 here, and I'm going to send this out to you. You guys can see what I'm talking about, okay? So that first problem here, my first question to you is, what should we call you, okay? And then take the integral of what's in your calculator with respect to you. 2 minutes before I close the poll on this.
Not a fact.
You're close. Alright, so let's go ahead and look at our answers on our poll. I'm going to stop the poll. Yes, so inside the parentheses, but which one? The first or the second?
First.
The first one, okay, you should be that x to the fourth minus 3x squared term. That's what I'm going to call you. Now, the integral of u to the fifth is none of these. Now, if I have u to the fifth, what rule should I use?
Power rule.
Power rule. So I should have u to the
six.
Over 6. Plus c, okay? And I am going to save these answers, okay, when we're going through this. So let's look at what the heck I'm asking you these things for, okay? If you like different colors, if you have different highlighter colors, okay, this is a good thing to, like, make sure you can separate these out. So the first thing I ask myself is, where could you be hiding? And the place I look is inside parentheses raised to a power. So I'm only going to call you the stuff on the inside of the parentheses. Now, if I'm going to change this to be in terms of you, I need all of my variables to be the same. So I need to change all of these x's into something with a u in it. So the next step in u sub is trying to figure out what the relationship between and dx is. So if I say take the derivative with respect to x, what's the derivative, not integral, derivative of x to the fourth? Minus 6x. What do you notice is left over in my integral? That's the change piece. That's the derivative of the inside. And then I'm going to move dx over here. And in place of 4x cubed minus 6x dx, in place of that, I'm going to put du. And then I'm going to have an integral that is just in terms of u. So I'm going to have the integral of u to the fifth. And I've changed my variable of integration to u. So with regards to like what the relationship between dx and du is. So this integral is 1/6 u to the 6 plus b. And so my final step is just to plug back in for u. What I need to tell you is, right, I add one and then divide by the new power. So the reason we do this derivative piece, I know you're like, I thought we were doing antiderivatives, right? The reason we do the derivative piece is to figure out what's the chain. What's the chain of u that I then need to substitute in here? I'm trying to figure out what that chain of u is that we did. Now you can always check your answer by taking the derivative and making sure you get back to the original, right? So if I took the derivative of this, like I would in number 4, I'd take the 6 and bring it down. What happens to my 6 and 1/6? So that would be x to the 4th minus 3x squared to the 5th times the derivative of the inside. So that's my right answer. Look at model problem number 2. I'm going to ask you to do the same thing. So look at this problem. Do not call u the entire piece. That doesn't help you. For somebody in each class has done that today. Okay? What piece of this should be called u? Use those bullet points to help guide you if you need to. Okay? What piece of number 2 should be called u? And then what's the integral of? The integral I put in your calculator.
You have to try to figure out what the chain is and rewrite it so it doesn't have the chain. Right? So like here, you have to be like, oh, that's the chain piece. Oh, that's the chain piece. So I'm going to rewrite it without the chain.
So this will be changed.
Alright, let's look at our answers here and see what we can start piecing together, okay? So, you should call u 5. you is just the exponential power. So u equals 5 sine of x. Now I also have to replace my dx to be a du. So my next step when I do u sub is to say, what's the relationship between du and dx? Take the derivative of u with respect to x. So what's the derivative of sine?
Cosine.
And I'm going to keep the 5. So 5 cosine. Now notice, and this is kind of your like check step as you're doing this, do you have a cosine x just chilling? Yeah, right? Like those match. Right? Now if I move my dx over here, I also get that those match. But do I have a 5 cosine x dx? I have a 10, but do I have a 5? So whenever we have stuff that's left over that doesn't match exactly, just divide that to the other side. Okay? Divide that to the other side. Which is why the highlighting really helps. It's like this is what's going to go in place for this, and this is what's left over. Okay? Alright, so I'm going to have the integral of 10 e to the u, and then in place of cosine x dx, I'm going to say 1/5 du. Is that equivalent substitution? Now, what happens with my 10 and my 1/5? I would have 2, and then my antiderivative of each of the u, you said was each of the u, plus c, and my final step is to plug in 3.
Why do you go from having a du to a z?
So I always get this question every year. Derivative with respect to that variable. Now, if I'm going to change everything to be u's, right, then I also have to change this to be du, so I need to take the antiderivative with respect to u.
So because you took the antiderivative, you already took it to u.
Right. Yeah. It basically goes away. But it always, it never gets asked whenever we've been doing this all last week with dx, and then magically we go to du, and we're like, but what happened to du? Took the integral with respect to u, and we're done. Okay? Alright, let's keep going on this. Look at model problem number 3. Okay, and I'm going to send that out your way. Thank you. will get you nowhere.
Yep.
Yeah, great. And those are extra colorful today. Extra, extra colorful. All right, which one do you want to check first? You or the integral?
You.
You?
Yeah.
The hardest part first?
I guess.
Okay, I guess. These are equivalent expressions, okay? I just changed it into like a 1 over function and then took the numerator over. And one of the check steps you want to start thinking about is like, okay, is the derivative of one of these pieces somewhere else in there? Specifically, the derivative of e to the 5t is e to the 5t, right? So that's going to help you start seeing quicker what we need to call u. So u is e to the 5t plus e to the power 2. Now I need to change this into terms of du. So what's the relationship between and dt. So if I take the derivative of e to something, what's the derivative of that? E to the times 5. And then what's the derivative of e squared? E squared is a number.
So 0.
So just 0. Okay? Let's go ahead and move dt over here. Alright, what pieces of that do I have? I know that this is going to be 1 over u, but what other pieces do I start seeing here? Ooh, I have an e to the 5t here. What else? Dt. What don't I have? So I'm just going to move that over here. So integral of 1 over u and then four, I'm just gonna go and do this one. Okay? So on this one, I start thinking like, okay, what are some pieces I could call you? So if I only call you pi times x squared, I'm not really gonna get a du that gets rid of my cosine or my sine. If I call it sine of pi x squared, I don't really get rid of my cosine cubed. Okay? So this one's a little bit tricky, and it's model problem four on purpose. I'm going to call it the cosine piece, but not include the third power. Okay? And so when I do that substitution in just a minute, it's going to be u cubed. Now let's think about why I chose that to be my u piece. So if I say let u be the cosine of pi x squared. Let's think about the relationship between du and dx. So what's the derivative of cosine? Negative sine of the inside times the derivative of the inside. What pieces do I have? What connections? Oh, this is the answer. They got harder, right? As we went through them. That's kind of the purpose. Now, here's your relief question. This is going to be our last thing, our little, like, check for understanding, and I'm going to pull this out to you. This is like a medium question, okay? So I don't want that last one for you to be, like, scared, okay, of this question here. This one's a nice medium question. So take about 2 minutes. See if you can figure out that whole
thing.
Tomorrow we're going to do more USUP, and Thursday we're going to do more USUP, okay? So, sure.
And that'll come with a good note, but I doubt she'll say no.
Hey, what?
Wait, by taking the drink.
What'd you call me,
that
horse?
Out?
Yeah, so
that's why. Okay. So
you want to get you.
10 seconds.
Yeah. So, on this way, what do you want? What do you want?
A square.
A square, right? So do you want that reason? Because you substitute
1/3. Oh.
So they equal.
Bye-bye.